Because see, Saturn, this is how we try to link it. Saturn is the karaka for the 6th, 8th, and 12th houses. It is the Dusthana houses. Dusthana houses are what basically? In one word, they show our weakness. It's very simple. I mean, it's nothing much not drastic about those houses. It will just show where is your weakness. That is why when a planet sitting there gets activated, as per dasha, you have tough times, right? Why do we
Definitely.
have tough times? Like take the example of sixth house. Sixth house is what? It shows the mess in your life. Any planet in the sixth house is in a mess. So when the dasha gets active, that is why they say for Venus that is like the Maran Karak Sthan. Maran Karak means where the planet feels like dying. So suppose that gets activated and your Venus is in the sixth house, then it's like saying you are staying with a messy partner who is making a mess out of your life. So then the purpose of Venus is to increase your happiness. You are single and happy and content. Now you get into a relationship to improve your happiness, but that partner comes up and makes your life more terrible. That is why you will see people or you hear sometimes people say, "Oh my God, I am so happy after I came out of that relationship. I am so happy." How that is happening? That means your happiness index, which was before, was now has gone down now after getting into the relationship.
Because your partner becomes your enemy, right?
Yes, sixth house is enemy.
Your wife is your enemy, or creates debts, or creates delays on your path of life, you know. And you
Yes.
also see this sometimes when you have a parivartana of 6 and 7, of how, you know, that can ruin relationships. But if Venus there, it's even more.
And another thing I have seen with seventh lord or Venus in the sixth house is that either of the two things happen. They fall in love with who, and that person doesn't love them back. That will happen. So they will feel as if they are punished. Or those who love them, they will not like to stay with them. So then, because then they feel if I stay with this person, I feel like as if I'm punishing myself. Or it can also happen that who you hate so much, then that person ends up coming and helping you. You know, in the Mahabharata, there is this story where Duryodhana was once captured by some of the higher celestial beings, and Bhima had come and rescued him. So it's like it's like a precarious situation. You know, it's like saying that you, the person who you always wanted to show that he's below you. Now that person becomes your savior. It's sometimes like that I've seen.
But the good thing is that it's a dushtana, but it's an upachaya. So in
Yes.
that time, it's gonna improve. So
Yes.
it might take decades, but don't worry if you have this position, you know, and you feel unlucky. It's gonna get better with time. So
Yeah, at the same
this is
time,
why.
if Venus is in six, then I've seen for finances it is very good.
Yes.
Because the person can do very good, make very good decisions in pertaining to finance, provided Venus is in a reasonable good dignity.
Exactly.
Otherwise, as you said in the beginning, Venus deals with our ability to make good choices. So if Venus is in the sixth house, then the person can have the ability to tell oneself that, okay, maybe relationships are not working for me right now. Okay, no problem. Let me focus on my career or my finances. Someday I will meet somebody, I'll fall in love again, or anything of this sort can happen. So these are the things. And yeah, one last thing I would like to say is regarding retrogression. As I said, take a note of the day when that retrogression is happening. That day, either of the two things will happen. Take the natural significations of that planet. Like Venus is what? Love, romance, relationship, women. And secondary, it is ruling some house in your horoscope. So something which has not happened will happen to you that. Now you may not realize it because it may not be very big. It may be something very small.
Usually it is, exactly.
Yes.
Usually it is very small,
Depending
yeah.
on your dasha, if your dasha is
Exactly.
having if your dasha is very difficult, and Venus is also suppose ruling difficult houses, then you'll have a very strong shift. But suppose your dasha is not that bad or it's not that terrible, then you may not feel that. But what I say to people is always make a note of the day when any planet goes retrograde, not only Venus. Like for example, there was one of my friend whose Saturn was the fourth lord. So Saturn went retrograde when this year? It was April 26th or April 27th, near about that time, I guess. I don't remember the exact date. So he had told me exactly on that day, exactly he started doing something related to his education regarding his studies. Exactly that day he was doing it. Exactly. Not a day before, not a day later. Exactly he was doing it. And can you believe it? September 1st or 3rd, I think it went, I think it was the retrogression stopped. And from September 1st week,
September, again
started going direct.
Direct.
Yes. So he said that day, exactly on that day, he completed his the work which he had started that time. And now here's the important thing. The catch here is that work which he did during that time from April end to September 1st week, that was something which was lurking from many, 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 many days. It was not happening. And because he's a Scorpio Lagna, so Saturn also rules the third house. So it will involve work related to communication or some paperwork, basically. Third house is what? Paperwork, right? To be very honest.
Yeah.
So he said, there was some problem in the paperwork or anything like that. So it was like both the things happened, but it was primarily fourth house because Aquarius is the Mool Trikon sign. It is falling in the fourth house. So primarily the retrogression effects will be of the fourth house, and secondarily it will be of the third house because Capricorn is the own sign which is in third house. So I'm like, always take a note, and especially I have seen Mercury retrograde. This is more prominent. Because it keeps happening very fast.
Every 3 times a year on average. Yeah.
Venus is like once in 18 months it goes. So we may not know that much. But Mercury retrograde I have always seen. You message some, like when Mercury was stationed that day. It was on 6th November, I guess. So I had booked a ticket. Because I was like, oh my God, Mercury will go retrograde tomorrow. So today I need to book the ticket at any cost. 7th morning Mercury went retrograde as per Germany time. So I booked a ticket on 6th afternoon or evening. All right. Considering that Mercury was still not retrograde, it was stationary. But even then I saw the effect. What happened was, in Germany, there's this blah, blah car system where somebody can take you in your car, and instead of booking a train or a bus.
Like an Uber. Yeah.
Yeah. So I booked a ticket from one place to another. And then within 2 days, that person said that, I'm not taking you. I'm not going on. I have canceled my trip only.
Mercury retrograde. Yeah.
Yeah. So now that is kind of an indication that some other side, like what I see, is that can be a challenging period to some extent for Mercury related issues. And I have seen when Jupiter goes retrograde, if you have some problem with your teacher, that can be a red sign. Or if you fail in something which you are doing again, that can also be a bad sign. Or suppose something great happens to you. Jupiter is retrograde and you meet a guru who is like great, and he's like, he has lots of knowledge, lots of wisdom. Then that period is going to be freaking awesome for you. You are going to, you will dance and you will dance and you will dance. And the another thing I want to say is regarding Antar Dashas here, because we always have to study transits with the Dashas and Antar Dashas. So this is another thing I have said earlier also, now also I'm saying that how do you know that the Dasha has started? Even for Pratyantars also I have seen. Like one time I was running my Mercury Pratyantar, and can you imagine what happened? There was one person, I'll show this to you. There was one person, I was sitting in a temple. Then out of nowhere, because I was supposed to stay in that temple that night and go the next day morning to my home back. So then this person came to me and he said, hey, what are you doing here? I'm like, yeah, I will sleep in the temple today. So I have something for you. And then he gave me this pen. Okay. And there's something,
okay.
And there's something very interesting. I'll show you. You're seeing this pen. It's like a normal pen, right? Nothing special here. Like a normal pen, do you see?
Yes, yes.
A normal pen, nothing special. So now you see. It's a magic pen, you see.
For free.
Yeah, so I was like, yes, my Mercury Pratyantar has got active. And you can check like that. Suppose Mercury Pratyantar gets active, or Venus also deals with gadgets. And that day, one of your gadgets spoiled. It can happen. So then you should understand that maybe this dasha can be a bit difficult or something like that. Or if something good, like you get a magic pen like this, then maybe you can know that, you know, some good news is about to come.
And we have to keep our eyes open to these things, without a doubt, because those are omens that, you know, are integral part of the experience.
Yeah, and there's this festival in India. It's known as Akshaya Tritiya, when sun and moon are both exalted.
Okay.
So that time, my mother had called me and said that, oh, you know, because see, Vedic astrology, what is the problem is nowadays, we are studying in YouTube and lectures and all this. We are very much disconnected from nature. Like that day.
In many ways. Yeah, in many ways.
That day at the end, I think Nishi had said, or somebody said that, go out, go in the nature.
Yeah.
So, my mother called me in the morning of Akshaya Tritiya and he said, oh, you know, today when I opened the door, I had seen a owl, you know, white owl.
And in India, white. Okay.
Yeah, there's this woman that if the white owl comes, then it means that Lakshmi Devi has sent her blessings. And if the black owl comes, it shows that Yamaraj has sent that messenger. No,
somebody. So one is richness and the other is death.
Yeah. So I did not know about this, and I Googled, and you know, as usual in YouTube, they will say green owl, blue owl, violet owl. They will give 10 answers that it is good, bad. So it's confusing. So I asked some astrologers and all of them said white owl is a good symptom. Okay. So then what happened was, in the evening, my mother called me and she said that your elder brother has got a very big promotion now. And that was like the omen which she got in the morning. So yes, as we discussed that day also, that it's very important to go out, and you know, it's like we can see the nature, we can see in older times they said that the rishis used to listen where the wind is blowing from and to which direction is it blowing. If it is blowing opposite, generally there's a direction where the wind will go. Sometimes if it is opposite, then the rishi can understand this is a bad omen. And in the Mahabharata also it is mentioned that when Duryodhan was born, that time the donkeys were, they were shouting. I don't know that word which they use for donkeys when they keep shouting.
Anyway. Howling? No.
Howling for wolves.
I speak Spanish, so yeah, I don't know either.
Yeah, so the donkeys were, you know, they were shouting and the crows were seen. And they saw wolves. So these are like inauspicious moments. And when Yudhishthir Maharaj was born, it was opposite. They had seen swans, you know, and there was rains, these, that. So it's like a long list is given. So when we read all this, then also we will know that what is happening. And sometimes I have seen when I'm doing consultations, like suddenly the connection goes off. Suddenly Wi-Fi is out. So that is also kind of a woman that this person is maybe not destined to get some help from.
Definitely. An astrologer. And we have to realize that the outside is a reflection of the inside. And this is one of the arguments why astrology in many ways, you know, is an efficient way to discuss a person's past, present, and future, besides their intrinsical personality and their intrinsical internal attributes. You know, and when you do readings, omens are an integral part of what you say to a client. You know, sometimes I once had a client that I was going to read to her, but the lights went out. And then we tried to do it via the cell phone and the app wouldn't work. And I couldn't get to her. And finally I did. And when we were talking, I mean, she never stopped talking. She never stopped complaining. Ooh. I was just, you know, she would talk like for 5 minutes and then I would say 3 words and then she would talk for 5 minutes. So in a way, you know, you get the omen from that, you get the idea from the omen by that experience. And when you practice not only your astrology or your spiritual practice, you become, you know, more enriched with wisdom and in a way more sensitive to these things, right? And you got to listen to them. And when they happen, when you see them, you gotta learn from them and see what happens. And these are exactly the stories you're telling me. You know, it's a way of how we come into contact with the harmony of the natural world that surrounds us, which is an integral part of the human experience.
Yeah, and I have also seen, like, I stay in this room, and four rooms apart, there's one girl who stays in a dorm. So this is like, I think, 6 months back. This is that time. So she had once come to my dorm because she was new, you know, then we kind of introduced to each other. Then she was just asking what to do and all. Then I said, I have a channel in YouTube. I upload videos on astrology and all this. And then she started asking, what is astrology? What is this? Blah, blah, blah. And then I said, yes, I can also help you if you want sometimes. Do you have your birth details, you know? So then what happened was she gave me the birth details. Everything was there. But she was like, I am born at 12 o'clock, but I don't know 12 how much or when. It's like it can be 12, 10 or 12:50 also. So then she said, wait, hold on. I will call my mother and ask. Then she called her mother, but the mother didn't pick. Then what happened is I said to her that you take your time. You come after some time. Then she said, oh, I called my mother. She's telling she also doesn't know. It is 12 or 12 something.
Which is very normal, by the way. Mothers sometimes don't know.
Yeah. So I was thinking that maybe there is something, you know, something has to be there. So what I did was I made the chart of 12 o'clock that time.
Okay? Prashna.
Yeah. No. Of that day.
Oh, the natal. Okay. Okay.
Yeah,
that day.
Yeah, exactly. Not the prashna.
Okay. Okay. Okay.
So I was seeing, because at max what will happen, the lagna will change once because it is within that realm only. The lagna cannot change twice because it will change in 1.5 to 2 hours, so it will go from one lagna to the next lagna. And then I saw that 12 o'clock there was a lagna, and then at 1 o'clock there was a different lagna. All right, so I was like, okay, that means either if it is in between, it will be this lagna or that lagna. Then something interesting I noticed in both the lagnas, either it was this or that, she would have an afflicted ninth house. All right, and in both of them, there was a ninth lord. The ninth lord was also badly placed, and the ninth house was also having malefics. And the malefics for both the lagnas, which was in ninth house, it was not. Like, it was not a Taurus Lagna where Saturn is the ninth lord and sitting in the ninth house. Then you can say, oh, ninth lord in ninth will protect. No, it was not like that. It was some other Lagna, and the malefics were in ninth house. And then I recalled James Braha sir had once come to my channel. So then he had said, whenever I open somebody's horoscope and I see that the ninth house is afflicted, then I understand that I am going to have a very hard time doing the reading, because ninth house is me. Because I am acting as the guru now. That house is afflicted. That means I will not be able to do it smoothly. Now, that person may have a good experience or bad experience, but I am going to have a bad experience.
Because in this case, you couldn't rectify the correct hour of birth.
Yeah,
in order so to have a correct. Yeah.
Yeah, even if I rectify, at max, what will happen? I will know either of the two lagna. But in both of the cases, the situation was so bad. Other things were fine. Sun, moon, and the ascendant for both the lagnas. But the ninth house was very severely afflicted in both. And the ninth lord was very badly placed for both. So then I understood that the situation is so difficult for this girl that even now, today, after 6 months, when we go out somewhere for a coffee or we go out to hang out somewhere, we still talk about astrology. Can you imagine? We talk That's for nice. 1 hour sometimes.
But if she has a bad ninth house, how are her studies going?
maybe there's some other combination in the chart. But yeah. Whenever the point comes to asking her about details, some problem or the other is always there. Either we reach home and then she says, oh, yeah, but I don't have time. I have to write that assignment. I have to write this. I have to write that. Or either I am like, oh, I have to rush. I have a reading or I have a recording like I'm doing with you now. So then I have understood that it is difficult in her case that I can actually give her a reading, because I can also always do, I mean, I can ask her some events with this lagna and that lagna. I can do the rectification. But what I see it as that the universe is not wanting, you know, to do that. So if I forcefully try to do it, now suppose tomorrow I go and knock her door. Hey, tell me about time. Today we will prove that the universe is, you know, we control the universe. If I try to do it, then also I'm very sure it will not help her. Of course, I am not saying that I want to see her horoscope, but what I am saying is that these are ways by which the universe tries to hint us, you know, that
definitely